Chapter 2, Party Night Revelations. The night was young in Compton, and the streets buzzed with anticipation. In a neighborhood where every evening promised new dramas, a local party was the epicenter of the night's unfolding story. Ace and Mello, friends bound by history but divided by choices, found themselves immersed in this nocturnal revelry. As they approached the pulsing epicenter of music and laughter, Ace felt a familiar tug of apprehension. These gatherings, while a staple of community life, were also a hotbed for the complex dynamics of gang culture, a culture that Mello, his best friend, was increasingly entangled in. Mello, with his charismatic swagger and easy grin, was a natural magnet for attention. His affiliation with the Crips wasn't just known, it was a part of his identity, worn as openly as the blue bandana that occasionally peeked from his pocket. In the dimly lit corridors of the party, his presence was like a beacon, drawing both admiring glances and wary looks. The party was a microcosm of Compton's youth, a mixture of excitement, aspiration, and the ever-present undercurrents of gang influence. Music blared from oversized speakers, colliding with the sounds of laughter and spirited conversation. The air was thick with the scent of barbecue and the tangy aroma of spilled drinks. For Ace, these parties were a navigation through a world he was part of yet apart from. He moved through the crowd, exchanging nods and handshakes, his demeanor cool but distant. The allure of the gang lifestyle was on full display here. The sense of belonging, the respect accorded to the colors, the unspoken power dynamics that played out in the room. Mello, meanwhile, reveled in the attention. His status as a Crip gave him a certain prestige, and he wore it like armor. Around him, the party seemed to pulse with a different energy, one that spoke of danger and allure intertwined. He was in his element, moving among peers who respected and feared him, his every gesture speaking of his allegiance to the gang. As the night wore on, the party swelled with more people, each arrival adding to the tapestry of stories that filled the room. Laughter mixed with heated debates, dance-offs merged with quiet corners of conversation. It was a world unto itself, where the realities of street life were both celebrated and lamented. For Ace, these moments were bittersweet. He saw in Mello the brother he had grown up with, full of potential and dreams. Yet, he also saw the path that Mello had chosen, a path that Ace knew led to precarious places. The party, with its vibrant energy and underlying tensions, was a reminder of the choices they both faced, choices that would define their futures in the unfolding story of Compton. In the thrumming heart of the party, Mello moved with an effortless charisma that drew people to him like moths to a flame. His influence was palpable, a product of his natural charm and his growing reputation in the streets. Mello wasn't just another face in the crowd. He was someone who commanded respect, a young man whose choices and actions rippled through their tight-knit community. Mello's admiration for Nipsey Hussle was well known among his peers. He often spoke about Nipsey not just as a musician but as a symbol of what someone from their streets could achieve. In Nipsey, Mello saw a reflection of his own aspirations, a blueprint for navigating the perilous path of life in Compton. His references to Nipsey were more than mere fan adoration. They were a sign of his deeper longing for significance and impact. At the party, Mello's association with the Crips was a badge of honor, yet it was also a shroud that cloaked him in an aura of danger. This duality was part of his allure, especially to the girls who gravitated towards him.
They were drawn by his status, by the excitement that seemed to swirl around him like a personal storm. To them, Mello was a figure of intrigue, a living embodiment of the perilous charm of the gangster lifestyle. But with this attention came the inherent pressures and dangers of gang life. Mello's every move, every word, was a statement of his allegiance. In the unspoken language of the streets, his actions at the party were as much about maintaining his status within the gang as they were about enjoying the night. The colors he wore, the people he associated with, the areas of the party he frequented, all were subtle signals, a language understood by those who live by the rules of the street. Ace, watching from a distance, could see the weight of these expectations on Mello. He saw the way Mello's laughter didn't quite reach his eyes, the way he scanned the room with the predator's alertness. For Mello, navigating these waters was a complex dance, a balance between enjoying the fruits of his status and maintaining the tough exterior expected of him. The dangers of such affiliations were never far from the surface. Rivalry simmered like a latent fever, ready to erupt with the slightest provocation. A wrong look, a misinterpreted gesture, could escalate into violence in the blink of an eye. It was a world where respect was earned and maintained through a display of strength and allegiance. As the party continued into the night, the mix of excitement and tension was a potent cocktail. For the youth of Compton, this was their reality, a life where choices were often limited and consequences were immediate. In the midst of it all stood Mello, a young man riding the crest of a wave that could either carry him to new heights or crash down upon him with unforgiving force.